The broadcast ministry of Christ Way Fellowship brings you victory for today. Exalting the Savior, evangelizing the seeker, and equipping the saint. Committed to the principle that you can have victory today and every day through Jesus Christ. Jesus said, "I have come that you might have life and have it more abundantly." And now, here's your host, Pastor Wayne Duncan.
Well, hello and welcome to Victory for Today. Thank you for tuning in. Hey, we're going to get right back to our Bible study. So if you have your copy of the Word nearby, open it please to 2 Timothy chapter 3. And we'll be right back in that passage in a moment. First of all, let me say this. You know what? God doesn't just love us all. He loves us each. That's right. He doesn't just love the world. He loves you and he loves me. I guess it takes God to do that. Amen. Well, listen, we have for a number of weeks now been moving on into a look at eventually the new world order. But as we approach that study, we're thinking about the present world order and how this world order that we are in now is giving us cause to believe that we are right here on the threshold of what the scriptures refer to as the catching away of the church, the coming of the Lord in the air to receive his own to himself. It's referred to usually as the rapture. And my dear friend, I believe that as we move on into our study, not just today, but in the days ahead, you're going to see that we're right here. We're moving every day. We're getting a little closer to that return of Christ. No one knows the hour or the day. Don't expect me to try to set a date. But Jesus said, when you begin to see these things come to pass, look up. And that's what we're doing. We're looking up, and we're finding things in the Word of God that encourage us and challenge us and help us to know just how we are to live. As a matter of fact, a week or two ago, we were over in the book of 2 Peter, and there was the question there, all these things being true, that is, that there's a whole new world coming, the world that we know is going to vanish, going to be done away with, there's going to be a new world, and God's going to set up a whole different situation. And the question was asked there, then what sort of people should we be? What sort of people should we be? And I think that that's one thing we surely do want to get firmly in our minds and in our walk, in our practice, in our way of life, to live the kind of life of those who live with their feet on planet Earth, but their eyes toward heaven and the soon coming of the Lord Jesus for us. So, hey, let's get back to 2 Timothy now. This is 2 Timothy chapter 3. And there's about 18 or 19, depending on how you break it down, different characteristics here of how people are going to be and how this is going to be intensifying as we move right on into this end of days or the end of time. It says in verse 1 that in the last days, there will be perilous times. Now, I think we can say amen to that. We're living in perilous times, in difficult times. It goes on and gives these characteristics of people being lovers of self, lovers of money, irreconcilable, treacherous, reckless, unloving, that is not having natural affections. We see that going on a lot today. Holding to a form of godliness, although they deny its power. That's really where we're going to try to pick up today and move on into another part of what the Apostle Paul said here to Timothy as the Holy Spirit gave him guidance. This form of godliness, but denying its power. Now, look at verse 5. He says, avoid such men as these, or turn away. Turn away from such men as these. You see, these are characteristics that are going to be, I believe, a part of the world, but also some of these characteristics are going to be influencing the church and people in the church also. That's right, people that call themselves Christian. He says, now look, he says, when you see these things going on, he says, turn away from such people. there are people, I want to say a few things here that I don't care if it ruffles feathers or not, but it's just the absolute truth. We are in a situation here, and I think in the church where we are so tolerant that we are trying to have a unity with the church, and we're being tolerant of everyone. I think that has to do with this post-modern age in which we live, where it's declared that there are no absolutes. The chief characteristic that people want to put forward now is, well, don't judge anyone. But you know what? I want to tell you something. There's something that's more important than unity, and what that is truth. Now, I'm not talking about the Baptist truth or the Pentecostal truth. I'm talking about God's truth. And hopefully we line up with God's truth, because there's something more important than just going along and getting along with people, and that is the truth of the Word of God. Now, here's something you need to understand. Now, I'm not talking about being self-righteous and just looking down on and putting people down for things in their lives, but I'm talking about having a broken heart over brothers and sisters that are straying from the clear teaching of the Word of God. We need to, as the Scripture says, go to those people and try to help them find their way back. I'm not talking about getting up and condemning somebody in a meeting. I'm talking about being brokenhearted and trying to work with brothers and sisters in Christ and bring them back online, as we might say, with the Word of God. So tolerance, that's just, we need to have a clear understanding of what we're talking about. We talk about tolerance. As a matter of fact, as we get on into this look at the end days, we're going to see that there are things that are going on right now in churches that may be tolerable to people, but they're intolerable to God. They have broken away and have separated themselves away from God's purposes and God's plan, His truth, and are substituting things like we've been studying about these last few weeks, about these characteristics that dominate mankind and even people in the church as we approach. As a matter of fact, this is spoken of in some commentaries as this apostasy, this great falling away. Well, mankind is falling away from the truth of God, but even in the church, we see people that are falling away from walking with the Lord according to His Word. Folks, let's be sure that we know that God's truth must stand above every other sort of structure that we set up, our precept that we set up. God's truth, that is to say the Word of God, must be our guide. There's all sorts of blending. There's all sorts of, I might even use the word infiltrating of churches by foreign ideas. When I say foreign, I'm speaking about foreign to Christianity, not nationality, although sometimes that does work into it, where things are coming into the church and people are coming into the church with all sorts of ideas that are not Christian ideas and philosophies that are not Christian philosophies and religious forms, as we'll see here, but not godly forms. And we need to be on guard. You know, I was thinking about this driving over this morning. There's a lot of people that call themselves Christians that may not have time to look in the Word of God for a few minutes in the morning, read a few chapters of the Word of God, but they always have time to check out their horoscope. Say, oh me, or ouch, or something. Now, you know I'm telling the truth about this, but folks, that's just an illustration of things that That has nothing to do with the Word of God. That has nothing to do with God's plan for us. No, my dear people, we're concerned with the one who created the stars, not the alignment of the stars. So let's put our faith and trust in the Word of God. And we're going to be talking about that a good bit here as we go on through this chapter. So let's get back to where we left off. He said, avoid, turn away from people like that. Turn away from them. Now, that doesn't mean we're snooty, we just turn our backs on folks. No, we care about their soul, but what it means is don't be affiliated. Don't align yourself with people like that. We might say, don't stay in a church that's flowing in this direction. And we've got so-called Christian denominations now that are ordaining people that are living a lifestyle that the Bible calls abomination. Now, don't stay with a group like that. Don't stay with something like that. Turn from those. Avoid situations and people like that. He says in verse 6, for among them are those who enter into households and captivate weak women, weighed down with sins, led on by various impulses, always learning, and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Just as Jannes and Jambres opposed Moses, so these men also oppose the truth. Men of depraved mind, rejected as regarding the faith, but they will not make further progress, for their folly will be obvious to all, as also that of those who came to be. Those came to be. Their folly came to be. So here's a paragraph that we could look at and think about, how does this apply to today? Now the first thing that I'd like to say here is that I think it was J. Vernon McGee, who was one of my heroes, I think he said that this is referring to women of both sexes, both genders. This is not gender specific. There are people that are apt to be captivated of both genders. And may I just say that in this day in which we live, one of the ways that I think that this is taking place, where you're seeing this situation of entering into households and captivating people, you know what? I tell you, I think that there's nothing like what goes on the television nowadays. I'm talking about in the secular media. I don't think there's much that goes on in that realm that isn't covered right here. This thing about entering into households and captivating people that have all sorts of needs and they're and guilt they're trying to deal with. They're looking for answers, but it's kind of like that song, you know, all the wrong places. That's where they're looking for these things, because they're looking to others, to people outside of the Word of God, of course, and people outside of the teaching of the Word of God to find these answers. We've had for years infiltration of ideas that are foreign to the Word of God being brought in through the guise of educated people, of people who have spirituality. Now, come on, you know this is true. You know I'm speaking the truth here. And I believe this is the modern way that these things are happening, where people are coming into your home by the media. They're being presented as spiritual people, as people of great understanding and learning and knowledge, great humanitarians, but they're bringing ideas into your home and into your heart that are contrary to the Word of God. Get away from that, folks. Get away from that. I'm not going to call any names. I think you can probably think of some people that are on the daytime and afternoon TV and on into the evening hours when these ideas are presented by people that are they're nowhere near being Christian ideas, nowhere near being biblical ideas. And we need to be on guard, child of God. We need to be on guard. Now, the culture, it's in this flow, but we need to turn away from this. Turn away, okay? Now, let's see what else we have to look at here today. Let's get down here to where he begins to tell Timothy, speak to Timothy directly, to charge him, to challenge him and us. Listen to what he says here. Look at verse 10 with me. Find verse 10. But you. Now he's talking about all these things that are going on up here. He says, but you now, you follow my teaching, my conduct, purpose, a faith, patience, hope, perseverance. Look in verse 11. Persecutions and sufferings, which has happened to me in Antioch and Iconium and at Lystra. What persecutions I endured, and out of them all the Lord has delivered me. Listen to verse 12. And indeed, all who desire to live godly in Christ Jesus will be persecuted. But evil men and imposters will proceed from bad to worse, deceiving. That's what we've been talking about, deceiving and being deceived. So let's go back here now. You see, the Apostle Paul and this young man, Timothy, young minister Timothy, they had bonds that went back for years. Matter of fact, Paul looked upon Timothy as his son in the ministry. And they were so close. They were so close. And he says, and actually, let's just say it this way. The Apostle Paul's life was an open book to Timothy, and it is to us too, because there's so much of the New Testament that has to do with, if not written by him, some of it in the book of Acts are written about him, and he's even mentioned in some of Peter's writings. So look, his life's an open book, especially to Timothy, who knew him so well. He says, you know about these things. You know about my teaching, my doctrine. So you know about my conduct, the way I live my life, about my purpose, what I'm directing my life towards, what my goals are, about my faith, my patience, my love, my perseverance or endurance, and all those sufferings and persecutions that he went through too. As a matter of fact, Lystra, which is named here, is one of the places where the Apostle Paul was taken out of the city of stone. That was Timothy's hometown. That was his hometown. He knew well about these persecutions and things that had happened to the Apostle Paul. His life was an open book to the Apostle Paul. And so when he says, Timothy, look, you turn from all this that's beginning to turn the hearts and lives of people that call themselves Christians, this culture that we're in, this world scene that people are buying into, the values of the world, the recklessness, the selfishness, all these things that we've been studying about for the last few weeks. And you can go back to, matter of fact, you can go to our website, victoryfortoday.com, and look at past programs and catch up if you're new to the broadcast. Or you can go on One Place and hear the audio, or Light Source and see the video. But our website, victoryfortoday.com, just go to archives, and there's over 200 messages and programs that are on there for you to look at. Matter of fact, you can even download it if you want to, make you a copy. It's all free. Just go right ahead and do that. I hope you will, and share it with others. But he's speaking here about those that that have wormed their way in. They're reprobate, it says in the old King James Version, reprobate regarding the faith. They're castaways. They're disqualified. And these people have influenced hundreds and millions of people, thousands of people. And so now he says, you turn away from that and you stay lined up where you've always been. You follow my tracks. You know, sometimes, you know, well, let me just say this first and be very frank and honest about it. You know, we all fail from time to time. We all wish that we had done things differently sometimes in the past. Sometimes even the most well-intentioned Christian will make a mistake. And we wish we didn't do that. And God gives us grace not to do that if we'll call upon him. And he gives us forgiveness and restored fellowship with him when we confess those sins. We talked about that last week. But you know what? people that call themselves Christians and have no regard for the representation that they have to others. Dear folks, if you're just living like everybody else, you have no regard for living for God or in godly ways, as the scriptures show us, you really, really ought to think about whether you've really ever been born again or not. You see, the Bible says that if anyone's in Christ, he's a new creature, new creation, and old things have passed away and all things have become new. And then the old person that we used to be before we got saved, we're not that person anymore. We're not perfect. We're not going to be perfect in the sense of flawless until we go to be with the Lord. But, you know, we're different than we used to be. What's that old thing about, I'm not what I ought to be, I'm not what I'm going to be, but thank God I'm not what I was. You know what I'm saying? So look, he's saying, you just follow right along. You keep your plow headed on down the road, as they might have said in a generation past. The Apostle Paul was well known to Timothy. There was no mysteries. You know, one of the things that I think that's going on in our culture today is that there's such a turning away from the Bible, from the Word of God, and what we do find is distorted so often that we don't have the road signs that we had a generation or two ago when the Word of God was more prominent and more highly regarded in our American culture. You know, when the Nazis invaded France, the French went out and they took down all the street signs. So the Nazis stayed lost most of the time trying to find their way around. Well, that was pretty clever. But you know what? The devil's done that to a lot of us too. He's taken down the street signs. He's taken down the things that used to keep us on track and keep us from getting lost. So we need to get back to the Word and get back to the Word in one big hurry. My dear friend, let's be honest about it. We need to get back to the Word of God. And so he's encouraging Timothy along these lines. He said, look, evil men and imposters, they're just going to go from bad to worse. They're just going from bad to worse. Look at verse 14. However, continue in the things that you have learned and became convinced of, knowing from whom you have learned them, and that from childhood you have known the sacred writings, which are able to give you the wisdom that leads to salvation through faith in Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Well, look, I'm going to get back to that next week. Let me stop now and remind you about the offers that we make each week. I'd like to send you a New King James Bible, absolutely free, and some other materials I'm going to describe. You can have, look, I'll tell you what, you can have a New King James or you can have a New International Version. Very easy to read, either one of those that you want, just specify it. Or if you read Spanish better than you read English, I have a Spanish Bible I will send you. I have a DVD entitled, Who is Jesus? I'd like to send that to you. Or, in English and Spanish, I have Beginning Steps, a little Bible study I can send you, English or Spanish. I've got a little booklet entitled Eternal Life, tells you how to get saved, or you can use this to help a friend find the Lord. I've got some children's tracts, English and Spanish, and then also English and Spanish. I've got this little booklet I've used since the mid-70s called Have You Made the Wonderful Discovery of the Spirit-Filled Life? And so I'd like to send all of this to you, your choice on your Bible, and these other things will come with it, absolutely free, no strings attached, no postage to pay, no handling. Wherever you are in the world, I will mail this to you. I've got, a Bible going to Romania and one going to Nigeria that I'll be mailing tomorrow. And so all across the United States, of course, and around the world, wherever you are, I will mail this to you absolutely free. No strings attached, no postage, and no handling. You won't be put on a mailing list to be solicited for funds. So that's for you. That's absolutely free. Now, here's what I would like to ask all of you to do, whether you want the Bible or not, and that is to pray for us, pray for Victory for today. We're a small church that has begun this worldwide ministry. Big step, big step for us. And so please pray for us, and that the Lord will guide us, He'll keep us on track, and that we will accomplish the purpose for which He has placed us in this ministry. We're trying to accomplish God's purposes in our generation. That's our motto, as a matter of fact, for our church. Then I'd like to ask you to not only pray for this ministry, but also tell others about it. We're on this same station each week at this same time. Now, some of you are seeing this on television or on the internet. Some of you are listening by radio. So we have different ways that this program is being produced and put out so that people can get it. But it's on this same venue, maybe that's a way to put it, same station, same time next week. We're a weekly program, so please tell others about it. And then would you do this? Would you pray about becoming a partner with us financially? And everything that you send, every nickel that's sent in, goes for this program. It doesn't go to any other purpose but just producing and presenting this program. A lady sent a very nice gift the other day. I almost brought tears in my eyes, and she sent a very nice gift, and she wrote down a little memo part of her check. She said, Bibles. Guess what I did? I ordered some Bibles, y'all. And so everything that you send goes for that purpose. We're not buying airplanes or condos or anything like that. This is all for this program to get the word out and let people know that God loves them and He has a wonderful plan for their lives. So if you want to be a part of that, just send your check to us at Christway Church, P.O. Box 250, Fairbanks, Louisiana 71240. Now that'll, Jim Stewart will give you that again at the end of the program. And if you're watching, it will be on the screen for just a few moments, and you'll be able to jot that down. That P.O. Box 250, Fairbanks, Louisiana 71240. All right, now, praise God. It's been good to be with you. And this is Wayne Duncan saying, the good Lord willing and the saints don't rise. I'll see you right here next time on Victory for Today.